Welcome to UNIGINE Programming Quick Start Tutorial, Creating and Deleting Nodes at Runtime. In this video, you're going to learn how to create a node and set up its parameters and position, how to delete a node when it is no longer needed. Now let us dive in and start developing our first C++ project for UNIGINE. In our project, we are going to need some objects. So let us write an auxiliary method to create an object mesh dynamic node and call it addMeshToScene. Write another auxiliary method to append some initial set of objects to our scene. Let's call it initObjects. And we are going to store the list of the nodes created at runtime in a vector. So let's get started. First of all, open your SDK browser, find your project and click Edit Content.
Now in the editor, delete or disable the default node and light probes, as the ground, sun and main player will be enough for our project.
Now we're gonna save our world, close the editor.
Now we can proceed to coding.
So, okay, first of all, in our header file, let us include a library that we are going to use, UNIGINE objects. In order to be able to use the objects, we're also going to inject the UNIGINE namespace. So in the private section of our AppWordLogic class, let us add a couple of methods. The first one is the one that creates a mesh and adds it to scene. We're going to call it addMeshToScene with the following parameters. The first one is the file name. If it is not specified, we're going to create a default box or load a mesh from a file otherwise. The second parameter is a mesh name. It's a name we're going to assign to the object. The third one is a material name. And the last one is a vector which determines the position of our node in the world. The second method we're going to use is going to help us to create an initial set of objects. Let us call it initObjects. And we're also going to declare our vector where we are going to store the objects of our scene. Our objects are going to be of ObjectMeshDynamic class, so the vector components will be ObjectMeshDynamic pointers. So now let us implement our addMeshToScene method in the AppWordLogic CPP file. First of all, we're going to create a mesh, as we declare a mesh pointer, call it a mesh, and call the constructor of the mesh class. We're also going to need an object mesh dynamic pointer. Let's call it OMD. Okay, now if the file name is specified, we're going to load a mesh from a file. For this purpose, we're going to use the load method of the mesh class and specify the file name. So if everything is successful, we proceed. Otherwise, we show the message are opening a mesh file to the user. So, if the mesh was loaded successfully, we are going to create an object mesh dynamic by calling its constructor and specifying a mesh. Otherwise, let us consider the case when the file name is not specified. Here we are going to create a default box by using addBoxSurface method of the mesh class. First we specify the name of the surface and then the sizes along all axes. We're going to use Vec3 class and our box is going to be 0.5 units in each dimension. Then we again call the constructor of the object mesh dynamic class and specifying the mesh. Now we're going to set the material for our object by calling the setMaterial method. Specify the material name and the pattern, which actually indicates that we're going to assign this material to all surfaces of the object. Then we're going to set the name of our object using the setName method, and we're going to set the position of our object in the world by calling setWorldPosition method. Now we're going to add our objects to the vector. And we're also going to report our progress to the console by calling the message method of the log class. Okay, and we'd specify the name of the object that we added. And we're going to perform some cleanup. We're going to call a clear method of the mesh class. So our method is ready. And now we're going to write another one that is going to create us an initial set of objects, our init objects method. Here we are going to create four boxes positioned next to each other. Using our addMeshToScene method, let's call our objects myMeshDynamic with an index. Assign a mesh base material to it. So now we're going to increment the index. Okay. Now that we created all our objects, we're going to report the progress to the console. Now using warning method, so that objects generation is okay. Now inside the initialization method of the world, which is called appWordLogic:init, as you know, and performs all initialization before starting the main loop, we're going to call our initObjects method. Now, another important thing we're going to do is performing a cleanup at the world shutdown. So let us insert the code removing all our created objects in the shutdown method of the appWordLogic class while we still have objects in our vector. We remove the first one from the scene, and remember we must specify the node pointer. That's why we use the get method
and call the delete later method.
And then we remove our vector also by clearing the pointer using the clear method. So, okay. Seems like everything's ready. Now we're going to launch and see what we've got. Well, now we have an initial set of objects to experiment with. And in the next section, we're going to work with cameras.